Hello everybody and welcome to Mr. Oz's Fish Room. I just wanted to do an update today as things have gotten out of control. I'm in the process here of building a 180 gallon severum tank, and right now as a result, as you know, you can't just throw a bunch of severums in the tank. There are issues concerning size and aggression and territory, and so it's taking a while, and now I've been working on it for about 2 months, and so far all I've gotten is one orange spotted red severum, three uarus, and one rokteil, and I have some red spotted severums and some super reds, but I don't have anywhere to put them right now, so they're not here. Right now I've put together another tank so that when I get my fish later this week, I'm going to put some of them in here as a temporary holding tank. So that's that, and right now I haven't really cleaned my tank, so they're kind of dirty. I apologize for that, but I just wanted to throw this together. You can see the glare off this tank. I apologize for that as well. But yeah, so right now I've got my 55 gallon with what you see right now. There's my red spotted, my three uarus, and my rocktail, and then I've got a bunch of Siamese algae eaters. Great fish, did a good job, and they just kind of help keep the peace. If you are familiar with Siamese algae eaters, then you know and truly appreciate them. Otherwise, if you're not familiar with them, they probably look like a bunch of not exactly the most attractive looking fish, but I think they're actually kind of cool, and given what they do, I think they're incredible. My plant tank is doing better. It's really starting to grow, so I've got I'm really excited. My celestial peral danios are starting to really color up and get bigger, and as you can see, they're just absolutely beautiful fish. In my opinion, the most beautiful fish in here. I love the coloring, and they're small, so they're not really coloring up just yet, but God, I love the spots and their orange tails. So I've got about a dozen of them in here, and they're doing great. And then my cherry barbs, the males, the bright red ones, they just kind of hang out in the plants. And my rummy heads, love them. Great fish, also arguably one of my favorites. And then I decided to throw in some neons just to kind of add some color. And they've added a really good, element to the tank. These are all really nice, peaceful fish. And then, of course, I've got my corydoras, and there's about nine of them in here. So, and then there's two clown plecos, probably about 2 to 3 inches, whom I rarely ever see. They live in this piece of wood here. This piece of wood has a bunch of different little like caverns in it, and so it's awesome. All the fish love to swim through it. So then I have a really cool piece of petrified wood here that I found amongst my travels, and then as you can see, the plants are doing great. I like the way this tank is coming along. This is my first real plan of tanks. I mean, I don't profess to be an expert or anything, but my CO2 reactor diffuser, this mixmix, I just went through one. It just basically blew up, so I just replaced it. And this little aquatek mini CO2 regulator is working out just great. And I've got a bunch of backup tanks. I mean, these CO2 tanks are like $18 a piece, so I've got like three of them. One's a 24-ounce and two are 20 ounces. So I'm probably not going to have to fill them up for, I don't know, 6 months maybe. I'm remaining optimistic. And then just temporarily here is holding / quarantine tanks. I'm trying this thing here with these incandescent Phillips lights. They're equal to 100 watts, and they are doing a spectacular job here in this planet tank. I've got some S reference here, which I happen to be particularly fond of. I love that plant. Got a little UV sterilizer running. Not the most attractive apparatus, but it definitely keeps the water clear. Got a little aqua clear HOB filter running, and as you can see, everything's just kind of thrown together, but I'm having fun. And then I've got my 29 gallon here. This is full. There are 9 rocktails in here, and I got them, quarantined them, and glad I did, because they had some sort of a fungal disease, so I've been treating that. And I've got some hornwort in here, so I think that's kind of like the panacea for aquariums. It helps the water, it looks pretty cool, the plants or the fish love to hide in it, and I can medicate the water, and the hornwort isn't affected by it. And actually, if you didn't know, the hornwort helps with the water pH, so it helps to stabilize the water. And if you're interested, look into it a little further, and you'll see what I mean. Kind of experimenting with the flood lamp here. Got all kinds of crazy stuff going on. And then a Marineland LED strip here. So, yeah. It's going kind of crazy in Mr. Rouse's fish room. So, hopefully within the next month or two, I'll have my 180 up and running. But I'm researching. I've decided to go with the sump. It's just way too cool. I've got to get a sump going for my 180, and it's probably going to be a 55-gallon sump. So, yeah, it's going to be a bit of work, but I'm going to have fun probably every second of the way. So, that's it. Little shelf never hurt, definitely. So. Oh, and I recently added, I should share, a RO buddy. And then I got 2 44 gallon plastic trash cans. The Rubbermaid Brutes are perfect, so just want to make sure. I might water hardness, my KH and my GH are just, they're so high just naturally because of where I live. I was pretty much forced to use this RO unit, and I think it was like $65, and the cartridges are like $10 each. I mean, it's a no-brainer. So, and I've got a sink right here already in my workshop, so it's pretty cool. Oh yeah, I didn't really show you guys my fish in here. I've got some of the coolest, at least in my opinion, loaches. These are called golden zebra loaches. And they are so beautiful. Just amazing looking. And then I've got a half a dozen rose lions in here. And I love them too. The goal ultimately is to get my severum tank set up, and then I'll have a lot of these fish in the 180, and then I can start to pare or trim down on the number of tanks. Having this many tanks is a lot of work, even though I've got the routine down, but anybody who keeps fish knows what I mean. It's just, there's a lot of stuff to do besides your hobby. Thing called life and family. So, anyway, thanks again for tuning in, and until next time.